comes the axe. Prove yourself.
The smoke gangs, they're going to end up running into the tiny, and that's a huge chilling touch coming out from Ancient Apparition. It means an easy kill on tiny. So yeah, that chilling touch.
For example, it's just way harder for the OD to contest those kind of things.
They're really aggressive here at the bottom lane, spamming abilities, constantly trees being thrown from Tiny, but all the way at the tower, the lane positioning right now seems like it's pretty good for the dire side. Top lane, Jonas Fan goes down, Madara's not going to be able to TP out though. Pablo will finish the... That's a 400 gold kill for Pablo as well, this early on in the game. He's got boots now as a result, he takes him out right here as they kill off Cinderin, and to what's necessary, either getting that Soul Rip or maybe the Tombstone. He's putting it in the middle lane, but back at the bottom lane, Ancient Apparition is going to be gone on, so with Untying TPing.
Is that for heroes that really need that advantage of the vision, like say Bop or Viper or OD?
And they're in trouble though, maybe next time the one in trouble. Madara's going to turn on a Hanskin, at least maybe try to get the turn go. Colfi Prox though secures that one onto the Undying.
Getting so many kills already, contrary to the 5 position of last game. He's actually getting picked off here.
Yep. Good find. Couldn't snowball in time.
Now that he has the Visage level 6, the birds just put you to the next level. That's pretty much what this hero is exactly, so he's gonna be totally fine. This is exactly what you want.
Well, bottom lane, they do kill Undying, but he got the Tombstone off, even healed a little bit to delay the kill eventually, but Healing Ward comes out from the final tribe, and they fall back themselves, not going to overcommit into that Tombstone, which they know is still up. So, another 10 seconds before it despawns here. Top lane, Keizu is able to initially, but the snowball still connects. Pablo continuing to play like a boss here. And with level 2 Blink, that cooldown is going to be too long. Omni Slash, enough damage. Blink is going to jump. It looks like he has. Keizu tosses in Venomancer, but Venomancer, does he have an ulti? No, he doesn't actually. Doesn't have the poison over just yet. And Ice Blast comes out of response, so Tiny put himself in that spot just to get a kill on Venomancer.
And they're not set up in position. That would be a free play, but you always have to be cautious, and you cannot go for those dives.
Oh, this Blink will actually be successful. Ancient Apparition.
The Basher is pretty much the only way he can actually contest him in the fights.
Maybe next time push down the Tombstone as well as the Flesh Golden Form. Cinderin is picked up. Keizu knew about the snowball. Picked up Ancient Apparition. And Keizu whipped as a result. And now once again he's in no man's land. Can he at least kill Hanskin? Nope, doesn't look like it. The Heal Ward's going to be enough. The Familiar's over here. Anti-Mage is right next to him. Oh boy, this is interesting. Is he going to Omni after the kill? Yeah, he's going for what a heads up play by Frost.
So many spells, it sets up for AA, Venno.
Speaking of Venno, they jump him here. This jump is successful initially. Jonas tanked up. He finally does go down. Hanskin also thrown out the Ice Blast nearby. And is now on the run himself. Nice job using that Ice Vortex to speed him up. But in comes a flying Amon. And they get the...
This Tombstone on Death Talent. Just having 2 Tombstones in the fight is just so annoying. And you feel really effective.
That's like, a kill.
You want to just die.
Yeah. Definitely good news for TFT. And oh, by the way, OD's also ahead and getting a kill here in the middle lane, it looks like. Yes, there you go.
They already have a hard time bringing him down. With this Aegis on OD, he's going to be able to be a monster in the fights.
Oh, Undying, not sure what the game plan is here. I suppose it was, maybe steal the Roshan kill, but...
Yeah. Didn't want to use the Eclipse to finish off Lich Doctor. Not really worth it.
Meanwhile, over here, maybe next time, that Soul Rip's not going to do anything because good old, well, I guess he used it offensively. Anyways, he's dead. Koikva, the Omni Slash again. Frost is just getting so much value out of these Omni Slashes. Obviously, a double damage rune helps, but another kill on Visage. And TFT is just, they're working like clockwork right now, going from lane to lane, doing the objectives at appropriate times. Well, look at that. Madara's dead meanwhile. That
obvious pick, like, yeah, there's a lot of magic damage, but it's not hard for TFT to just run from lane to lane because the anti-mage cannot, like, come to anything.
Yeah.
Uses Aegis.
Oh, Tiny. Tiny's gonna get bursted down. Not the heaviest burst, I guess, but the orbs will finish the job, and no buyback for Keizu there. Yeah, Undying's really not useful right now either. Good point. In fact, Undying, despite not being the most useful, they're still going to go in. The snowball in. Witch Doctor again is picked up for the dieback. Maybe next time's going to fall as well. No buybacks to be had. Visage going to be picked off. Same story for him. And now that's now. He's not going to get solo kill, though. Well, okay, OD changes it. He just flies in out of nowhere. And they do find the easy kill. Hanskin will take it with the ice blade. Jump him, he just presses R. And the fight commences. Or he can do this too. He four steps in, presses R. Kizu puts a toss onto Air. Air's in a bad spot. Can he imprison him in time? Yes, he can. He's good for now. That Poison Nova taking people down, though. Frost will finish the job on maybe next time. OD, he blinks on out the night.